Glory to God, everyone. I'm Prophetess Sherita Berry, and I just want to touch on something on tonight. Not going to take up too much of your time. I can say I won't, but no telling how the Spirit of God will move on tonight. But I want to touch on something entitled Godly Witness. Glory to God. When it comes to witnessing to the unbeliever, the sinner, the just, as well as the unjust, godly witness. Glory to God. When we witness to people, whether they save, whether they're a backslider, whether they're a sinner, an unbeliever, whether they're from different types, different religions, backgrounds, we have to use godly witness. Along with godly witness, it requires godly wisdom at the same time. We are not to condemn a person. Why? Because let me read something to you all. Glory to God. From the Word of God on tonight. Oh, in the book of Romans. Please bear with me. Romans, the 8th chapter, verses 1 says, there is therefore now no condemnation to which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. Romans 1:17 says, for therein is righteousness of God, revealed from faith to faith, as it is written, the just shall live by faith. Let me tell you what condemnation means. Condemnation means strong disapproval. Glory to God. Condemning someone to a punishment and sentencing. What does condemnation mean in the Word of God? It means wrong, evil, weighing evidence without reservation, pronouncing guilt, convict, sentencing, doom, condemn a person to die. Now, before Jesus Christ came on the scene, some people call him Yahweh, some people call him Yeshua HaMashiach, our sin was immediately judged, and you was immediately sentenced to death. But because now we have Jesus Christ, he has given us grace, and there's no condemnation in Jesus Christ. God does not condemn us, glory to God. But when he speaks to us, he uses wisdom, and he also speaks to us with love at the same time. He also takes us to the Word to back up what he is saying and speaking. When it comes to salvation, when it comes to deliverance, because we are ambassadors of Christ, glory to God, and because we are servants of the Most High God, when it comes to witnessing, we're to use godly witness. We're to use godly communication. Glory to God. We are required to witness with love, not condemning a person to hell. We are to share the good news and the gospel of Jesus Christ. We're also to share our testimony if you are led by God. Everything that we witness to an unbeliever, a backslider, those that are of other religions, glory to God, we are to back it up with the Word of God. Now, you cannot talk on a subject that you have not been delivered from yourself. But better yet, it's best to go get someone else that you know that has been delivered from that thing, that can witness to that person and at the same time witness to you. There's no condemnation in Jesus Christ. Glory to God. Jesus never drew the person never witness to a person out of hate, out of being evil, of spitefulness, but he witnessed in love. Glory to God. He taught repentance. He told them about hell and heaven and the kingdom of God and our inheritance and eternal life. But there's nowhere you will find God, Jesus, condemning a person. Remember the woman that they was about to stone because of her wrongdoing. They was about to stone her to death because she committed adultery. Not one time did Jesus condemn her of her faults, of her wrongdoing. He simply knelt down, written in the sand, and he told them, "He who without sin, let him cast the first stone." Then he turned around and told her, "Where are your accusers?" She said they were gone. And he told her, "Now go and sin no more." Another example is the woman at the well. Jesus already knew that the men that she had was not her husband, even the one that she was with. But there's nowhere that Jesus condemned her. Nowhere. We're to witness in love. Everything that God gives us to witness to people, we're to witness to them with godly wisdom, godly communication, and back it up with the word. We're in no shape or fashion or form should be condemning a person to hell. Why? Because we ourselves, we don't have a heaven and hell to put a person in. Only God does that. God punish people, not us. God brings about judgment, not us. We can judge rightly and justly, but when it comes to judgment, we're not to condemn a person. Oh, because you did this and you did this, you going right to hell. No. How can you be a good witness for Christ and you trying to send somebody to hell and they haven't even had a chance to ask for forgiveness? Isn't that something? I wanted to bring that to light on tonight to let you all know that we're not supposed to condemn a person. We have no heaven or hell to place a person in. We're to witness justly, rightly, in love. We're to lead them to Christ with love, not with condemnation, not with hatred. Not by taking a Bible and slapping them upside their head. The word of God says, if you draw nigh to me, I will draw nigh unto you. We're to help them draw nigh unto God. Not along the way condemn a person. That will cause them to turn around and say, I don't want to know that God you know. I don't want to serve the God that you serve. Why? Because your witness, the way you went about witnessing to that person was way out of line and way out of order. Go and read Romans 8 and 1, Romans 1 and 17. To God be all the glory.